Do you sometimes have clients who simply just can't pay the invoices that they owe you? Well, then you should write off those clients using the best method in QuickBooks for writing off invoices. It's called the items method of writing off uncollectible invoices. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. This video is a bonus video. It was added to our receivables course after the fact by popular demand of students who took the course. I originally excluded writing off invoices because I assumed it would be better to have your accountant write off the invoices using the accountant's toolbox. However, there are many bookkeepers that wish to write off invoices themselves, and that's what this video is for. You will not be able to follow along step by step because this video is not part of the continuous story that we used in our accounts receivable course where one video followed the next. It's simply a demonstration for you to be aware of how you would write off invoices if you chose to do it yourself. So what's the deal with writing off a customer's balance? Well, first, you have to determine that a customer's balance is uncollectible for reasons like bankruptcy, disability, death, or something else. Right now, the invoices remain in your customer records as unpaid invoices. So how do you remove them if you know you can't collect on them? You have to create an account in the chart of accounts that represents the expense that this costs you when you write off uncollectible invoices. And the name of that expense is bad debt expense. Now, I have already added bad debt expense to this little chart of accounts in this little QuickBooks file just to demonstrate how to write off invoices. So there are very few accounts in this chart of accounts because this file is just to demonstrate the writing off method. Notice accounts receivable and sales are the only accounts that have a balance in the chart of accounts just because I wanted to put the minimum in the file to be able to demonstrate how to write off the invoices. And here are the six open invoices that were created that add up to the sales income and the accounts receivable. Now, the bad debt expense lowers your profit and lowers your net income on your profit and loss statement. So what happens when you write off a customer's invoice? Well, accounts receivable, where that customer's balance is staying, goes down because you just wrote off invoices and lowered a customer's balance. But on the other hand, bad debt expense goes up because that expense account represents all the money you lost for invoices that you needed to write off. The items method of writing off uncollectible invoices involves three simple steps. The first step only needs to be done once. You set this up by creating an other charge type of item on the items list and then connect it to the bad debt expense account. So let's go ahead and do that now. Here is the items list, items list, and in the bottom left, click item, new. Now the type is other charge, and you can name it uncollectibles. You can name it anything you want as long as you know what it is. but you have to connect it to the bad debt expense account and then click OK. Once you've done that, your item is now on the items list ready for us to use in the next two steps that we will do each time we write off invoices. Step two, on the day that you write off the invoice, create a credit memo and use the bad debts other charge item that you just made. And the third step will be to apply that credit memo in the receive payment window. You will apply the credit memo that has the bad debt to the invoices that are being written off, and that is what will wipe it out of the customer's balance, so you will not see the uncollectible invoices in the open invoice report. So we only have to do step two and three each time we write off invoices. For example, let's imagine on May 6th, 2020, we determine that Alan Arby cannot pay. Okay, we will do step two and step three, and we said it was May 6th. So first, we click custom. Well, let's open the open invoice report so that you can see what's going on here. First, we click customers, create credit memo. Now, we choose the customer, Alan Arby, and the date is May 6th, and the item that we put on the credit memo is the uncollectibles item that we just made. Just click OK. We know what we're doing. Now, how much should we write off? Well, if you look at open invoice, Alan's balance is $2,000. So even though it's spread out between two uncollectible invoices, you really should put in the credit memo the total of the customer's balance. So this way you can wipe it out in one shot. And all you have to do is click save and close. And now we will click apply to an invoice. Now here's where step three comes in. Click OK. And we're going to apply the $2,000 to each of these two and click done. Now you can see that the two invoices have been written off and they no longer appear in the open invoice report. Here's Betty and here's Priya, but no Alan. And if you check the results in the trial balance, you'll see that bad debt expense showed up for the first time as $2,000 and accounts receivable that was $6,000 a moment ago decreased down to $4,000. And if you double click, you can see the last transaction for accounts receivable was this credit memo, bringing it down to $4,000 balance. If you were writing off many uncollectible customers, it might save you a little time to use the accountant's tool for write-offs, which is called the client data review, instead of making a credit memo for each one. But in order to use this tool, you must be logged in to your file as the accountant user or using the accountant's edition of QuickBooks Desktop. It uses the same item setup in the prior example. So even if you are using the accountant's toolbox, you still have to put an expense account in the chart of accounts called bad debt expense, and you still have to create the other charge item and connect it to bad debt expense before using the accountant's tool to write off the invoices. The accountant's tool will just save you time so you don't have to make a credit memo and then go applying that credit memo in the receive payment window. So, for example, on May 10, we determined that Priya cannot pay. We will use the client data review to write off the invoices, and you will see it's the same way. Now, before we do that, you'll notice that accounts receivable is $4,000 and bad debt expense is $2,000. So accounts receivable will decrease and bad debt expense will increase for Priya's invoices. And you can see Priya has two invoices for $1,000 each. So that means that accounts receivable will go down by $2,000, Bad debt expense will increase and become $4,000, and these two invoices will disappear from the open invoice report. To use that tool, you click Accountant, Client Data Review, Write-Off Invoices. Now, you can see if you make a custom date and you go forward to make sure that you're in front of the date that of the invoices that you're writing off. I think it's May 10, and then we click Refresh. You see all the invoices are eligible because they're all before that date. And you could filter it even further by putting amounts balance, due, less than, and you can explore and experiment with the filters on top. But it saves you time if there are a lot, because all you have to do is click the check mark on the invoices you wish to write off and then choose the item from the items list that we created before in order to write off, and then you make sure that you go forward to the date that you want the write-off transaction to be recorded. You then click Preview and Write-Off, and then you double-check, to make sure that these are the ones you want, no more, no less. Then click Write-Off. Now they're gone. And notice, close, when you go to the open invoice report, Priya's invoices are no longer listed there. Priya no longer has a balance. And just as we expected, accounts receivable has decreased by $2,000 and bad debt expense has increased to $4,000.